Let's talk about conflict types. Not all conflicts are equal, and people can have a lot of different reactions. But we can usually group conflicts into two major groups, which are hot conflicts and cold conflicts. And although you can use the same tools for both, it's important to understand the differences between both. Let's take a look.
When a conflict does break out, people can have many different reactions. It's funny that when you think of conflict, you probably think of two people arguing loudly over each other, a shouting match. But in reality, conflicts come in many shapes and sizes, and all of them, make no mistake, must be considered conflicts. Someone avoiding something, being passive-aggressive, or others are all forms of conflict, and the way to deal with this is also mostly the same. But nevertheless, it's important to realize the different types of conflict that you may be dealing with. One possibility is that the person may just outright avoid the issue, pretend that it didn't happen, or pretend to agree just to move on, false compliance. Another possibility is that the person may bottle things up and constantly become more and more stressed, and possibly, once they can't take it anymore, they eventually blow up in your face. Another possibility is that the person may become more aggressive, even being verbally abusive or just taking an accusatory stance, being defensive. Or another possibility is that they may become passive-aggressive, sabotaging things on purpose to make their point without a direct confrontation, or even poisoning other people behind the scenes. Despite the different types of reactions, these can usually be grouped, in a very broad sense, into hot or cold conflicts. Hot conflicts are the ones based on too much intensity, aggressiveness, insults, verbal abuse. It's what you probably think of when you think of a conflict. Cold conflicts are the ones based on a lack of communication. So, passive aggressiveness, voluntarily withdrawing, avoiding the topic, even becoming delusional and ignoring the facts, or pretending that everything is fine, all fit this pattern. While the general way to address both of these is usually the same, and we're going to take a look at it, including techniques such as applying empathy, showing respect, making the person feel understood, and trying to reach an equitable conclusion for both sides, it's important to add an extra layer of understanding in hot conflicts so that you can slowly calm down an aggressive person and bring them back down to the realm of logic so that they're reasonable. And for cold conflicts, to proactively stimulate communication because the person is going to withdraw and you need to be the one to slowly bring them out. What are some implementation pointers in terms of the different conflict types? The first is objectivity. Despite the type of conflict, remaining objective is always essential. If the other side feels disrespected, ignored, or victimized in some way, things will get worse. And in many cases, they already do this, even if you are objective. So if you're not, it'll be even worse. The second is that people can have wild swings. People usually do have one pattern. Some just avoid, some just become aggressive, and so on, sure. But it is possible for people to swing wildly. For example, someone very aggressive can be put in their place, and in the future, they don't speak their mind anymore because they're stubborn or they're pouting. But on the other hand, someone with a cold conflict that is withdrawn and is bottling things up and doesn't speak up may end up blowing up and becoming very aggressive when they actually can't take it anymore. Diagnosing is crucial. As people can have so many different reactions, it's important to assess the ones they may have. When something may be wrong with them, there may be a conflict there. And finally, remember that all of these types are conflicts. Conflicts are not just when people are aggressive and in each other's faces. All of these types are conflicts and should be taken seriously. What are some do's and don'ts of the different conflict types? Do's. Do have that weird, awkward conversation to really figure out what may be wrong with someone. It's better to have a small conflict now than let it grow and have a bigger one later. Don'ts. Don't assume that cold conflicts are not conflicts. Behind every attitude of withdrawing and avoiding, there is a reason, and chances are this situation could have been finessed. What are some examples of the different conflict types? The first is a screaming match. Again, it's probably what you think of when you think of a conflict. Two people being aggressive, shouting in each other's face. It's not the only type, but it is a type. Another example is someone being passive-aggressive. They don't fight the other person openly, they poison other people behind their back, or they sabotage what the person wants to do. Make no mistake, this is a type of conflict as well. And finally, avoidance. When someone avoids a person or a topic that they just don't want to deal with, that is a conflict. They may be trying to avoid the confrontation, ironically, but avoidance itself is a type of conflict. What are our key takeaways here? The first is that there are multiple types of conflict. Everyone deals with things in their own way, so conflict comes in many shapes and sizes. But all of these are conflicts, and all of them must be handled, usually in the same way. Then, the different types of conflicts can be broadly grouped into hot and cold ones. While hot conflicts are about aggressiveness and intensity, cold conflicts are about avoidance and withdrawing.
So as you see, conflicts can be grouped into hot or cold. And although the tools that we're going to use are going to be mostly the same for both types, it's important to keep in mind that for hot conflicts, the person is aggressive and they need to calm down. And in cold conflicts, the person is just withdrawing and they need to connect with you more.